scientist. I'm writing some observations in my science notebook. As we have learned about mammals and fish, I have noticed that there have been two options for each characteristic, like live birth or eggs, warm-blooded or cold-blooded, gills or lungs. But I've just found a characteristic that doesn't follow the same pattern. Remember how we learned that mammals have hair or fur and fish have scales? Well, those aren't the only two options. Some animals have feathers. Why do some animals have feathers? Fish and mammals don't have feathers because feathers are a characteristic that is only found in birds. But we shouldn't get feathers confused with flying. All birds have feathers, but not all birds fly. For example, ostriches are covered with giant feathers, but their wings aren't strong enough to lift their big, heavy bodies off the ground. And feathers aren't on every animal with wings either. Bats have wings and are able to fly, but their wings don't have any feathers, and their bodies are covered in fur. In fact, bats aren't birds, they're actually mammals. So, just because an animal has wings or can fly doesn't automatically make it a bird. You have to look for feathers. But why do birds have feathers? Well, there are lots of reasons. Many birds have adapted to use their feathers to help them fly. Feathers are curved, so when a bird flaps its wings, the curved shape helps to push the air back, which helps them lift up off the ground, balance, and even steer in different directions. Feathers are also very light, which is important for keeping birds in the air. Birds that are heavy, like the ostrich or penguin, often do not have feathers strong enough to lift them off the ground. Feathers also provide a bird with insulation. Insulation is a material that stops heat from moving around, so feathers keep warmth inside a bird's body. Birds, like mammals, are warm-blooded creatures, which means that they don't adjust to the temperature of the outside air, and they need help staying warm when it is cold outside. Just like dolphins use blubber to keep them warm in the water, birds' feathers work like a jacket, protecting the body and keeping it warm. Feathers can come in all different sizes, shapes, and colors, from the tiny feathers on a hummingbird to the beautiful pattern seen here on a peacock. Many birds use their feathers to help them communicate with other animals. For example, the peacock's long feathers often lay behind him, sort of like a tail. But if the peacock becomes scared, the bird will lift those feathers to make himself look bigger so other animals won't bother him. Birds also show off their feathers to get the attention of other birds nearby and flap their feathers in certain ways to let others know when they are happy, angry, or scared. Feathers aren't the only thing that helps us classify birds. Did you know that birds don't have teeth? Instead, all birds have a beak that they use to help them eat. Since birds don't have hands at the end of their wings, beaks also are used for picking up and carrying objects, protecting themselves, and feeding their young. What do birds feed their young? Instead of providing milk like mammals do, birds often feed their babies the same thing that they eat, only mushier. Many birds use something called regurgitation to feed their young. Regurgitation happens when a bird chews the food and spits it back out to feed to the baby. And here's another characteristic of birds. While all mammals give live birth and fish can either give live birth or lay eggs, all birds lay eggs in order to reproduce. And unlike fish who have no legs and mammals that can have no legs or two or four, to be classified as a bird, the animal has to have two legs along with a set of wings. And don't forget, those wings need to have what on them? Feathers, that's right. So now we know that birds have feathers to help them fly, communicate with other animals, and help control their body temperature because they are warm-blooded animals. And that's not all we learned. We now know that birds are two-legged animals that lay eggs, have beaks, and do not feed milk to their babies. The next time you're out in nature, try to spot some birds. What characteristics can you see that will tell you if you're classifying them correctly? As always, remember, science is all around you. Hey.